Damn it. Harold's here.
You backstabbing witch! You ratted us out!
Dr. Blackwell, I know we've had our differences, but this...
For your information, I had nothing to do with Mr. Harrow's sudden appearance on our doorstep. But thank you for confirming how little faith you have in me. Now, I don't presume to know how things work for you, gentlemen. But I can assure you that Calico wasn't built on broken words and betrayed confidences. Women in my position don't have that privilege. Now, I assume you have the plant?
We do.
Good. And there are clean syringes and alcohol swabs in the lab.
5 minutes is all we need.
Mr. Gravener's looking for you, sir. He's in the basement with your father.
Come on, William. I've seen you survive worse. You can beat this. I know you can.
Squeezing my brain. There's some thoughts in here that aren't mine. Oh, I see her, Jesse. Oh, no! You must stop her before... Wait. I see a sign. Dickinson! She's in Dickinson!
I need to get to Dickinson. Tough old bastard, he's turning it around on her.
It's gonna be a hard sell to Harold.
Gotta try. You keep an eye on him. And keep your hands off that switch.
Sir? Mr. Harrow is waiting in the briefing room. He's being himself, if you know what I mean.
I assure you, Mr. Assistant Secretary, we came to you as soon as we knew.
God damn it. Like I don't have enough going on already. Where is he anyway?
Assistant Secretary Harrow, sir.
Agent Rentier. Dr. Blackwell brought me up to speed on your father.
Sir, we...
I know. It couldn't have been easy. His shadow will loom large over us all. Please accept my condolences on behalf of a grieving nation. Try not to wallow in grief. It only leads to blunder. And this country desperately needs success.
Aside from the news of your father's tragic demise, I've also briefed the Assistant Secretary on the successful destruction of Felicity's leech factory in McCallum Sawmill.
That and a penny will buy me a cup of warm piss, Doctor. No one is safe while that crazy she-beast and her army of freaks are on the loose. And do you have any idea where she is? No.
Actually, I do, sir. We have intel that she's currently in Dickinson.
What intel?
Can't say, but it's 100% solid.
Great. You can head for Dickinson after you get back from Kingston.
Kingston?
There's a case containing some very sensitive information there that I need picked up.
But sir, the Dickinson lead. There's at least three interstate railroads there. It might be a part of Felicity's transport.
Very well. You there. What's your name?
Only? Virgil Only?
Do you know your way to Kingston, Only Virgil?
With all due respect, Mr. Assistant Secretary, Virgil is our top engineer. He is not fit for field action.
I don't give a watery shit about his curriculum fucking vitae, Doctor. I'm funding this circus of yours, and I want those papers back now.
I'll get them for you. What do I need to know?
We recently got our hands on a partial list of companies tied to the Andalusia Financial Services Group, like McCallum's Mill and the Kingston Oilfields.
Debano.
Debano indeed. He and his maniacal brat are up to their assholes in illegal acquisitions, and the government intends to seize their not insubstantial portfolio.
Sounds like you need a lawyer, not a vampire hunter.
Tried that already. I even sent in the blasted National Guard to secure the papers. But the place was guarded. That's where you come in.
So what exactly am I looking for?
Based on the final telegram from my forensic accountant, Andalusia's portfolio of holdings is stashed in a briefcase, presumably still at the Kingston Oilfields Bureau on the far side of the lake.
I still don't get why it's more urgent than looking for Felicity and Dickinson.
Wars cost money, Rentier. And unless you've forgotten the incident at your former headquarters, we are at war. This could very well turn the tides in our favor.
Let's get this over with.
You all right, folks? I need to find the office.
You crazy? The whole area's been totally overrun by bloodthirsty freaks!
The National Guard's fighting back, but there's too many of those monsters.
If they don't get some help soon, we're all goddamn doomed.
Easy. Taking it. Take that.
Per your inspections, I have assessed the value of these assets, and I can assure you that the Kingston oil fields are still pumping and extremely profitable, if properly managed. They can bring in hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars per year.
Ugh!
Okay.
The National Guard flooded the fields, but my friends are stuck on the other side.
Thank you, stranger. We thought we were goners. Is there some way we can repay you?
Yeah, you can point me towards the oil company office.
Oh, it's on the other side of the lake. Though you're gonna have to drain it to get over there. Release all counterweights and you'll open the sluice gates.
Let's drain this sucker.
I hope you make it, sir. You sure it's safe for us to leave now?
Road clear.
Thank you for letting us out, sir.
Burn, you bastards!
Is that it?
Hey! Who's there?
Money?
Shit. For a second there, I thought you were one of those demons. The National Guard barricaded us inside here before they headed off to protect the company office. If you want to find the man in charge, you need to use that crane to move those crates.
Through.
Thanks for letting us out.
The office, where is it? I need the man in charge.
There's no way to get there from here.
Unless you use the zip line from the top of that tower, that'd be crazy.
Please, you gotta help my buddies. Once you get on the other side, just follow the pipes. It's a kind of maze, but just keep going.
So glad you made it, sir.
God bless you, sir.
I can go see my family now.
After a closer examination, I believe these trust documents are suspect. Every 30 years, the property rights are transferred to the next generation. However, I believe that Peter DeBono has likely been deeding them to himself for who knows how many years. Sincerely yours, Jonathan Q. Biddle.
Take that.
Jesus.
Oh.
Thank you. far as the pipes go.
I fucking hope that's the right way. Run! Run!
Time someone sent in the cavalry. I've been hiding here for a week.
This ain't a rescue mission, so watch your mouth. I'm here to pick up some documents for Assistant Secretary Harrow.
Documents? I don't know anything about any documents. Oh, these documents?
You must be the accountant.
Jonathan Q. Biddle at your service. Mr. Harrow promised me immediate backup, as long as I kept this safe.
Harrow's written you off, Biddle. Sent me for the case, not you. All I know is that DC wants that portfolio seized.
DC? What an asshole. Harrow isn't trying to leverage this property for the government, you ape. He wants it for himself. He wrote me into this scheme for a cut of the profits, and now he's hung me out to dry. That asshole.
How big a cut?
10%.
Hope it was worth all those soldiers' lives, you greedy little pissworm. I'll take that.
Whoa, wait! What about me? How'll I get home?
Walk.
turning the tides my ass. More like lining your own pockets, you slimy shit.
What the hell are you... Biddle. Oopsie daisy.
You sent 24 National Guardsmen to their deaths for a paycheck. When the president gets wind of this, you're a dead man.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's just that the way the veins in your forehead are throbbing, it's so comical.
Mr. Assistant Secretary, these accusations sound serious, and...
First of all, it's Mr. Secretary now. As in Secretary of War. As in the fucking right hand of God. Secondly, do you think the President of these United States is gonna give a royal fuck about the pissant accusations of a podunk? Go ahead, Rentier, do it. Give me a reason to throw your cowpoke ass into Newgate and flens your father's legacy to the bone. The Harrow Institute has a much better ring to it, don't you think?
Mr. Secretary, maybe it would be for the best if you...
Maybe it would be best if you stopped interrupting me, you groveling mule! You want to make yourself useful? Get to the kitchen and fetch me a cup of coffee! Now fuck off and find some vampires to kill. That's much more your speed. You want something done right, you gotta do it yourself. Bunch of useless clowns.
Longevity. I'm surprised voltage that high didn't burn it out.
It's all about the percentage of copper in the alloy. Here, I'll show you my notes.
Seriously? I would love to see your original research. It would be an honor.
Virgil and I were just having the most invigorating discussion.
I was telling Director Rentier about my ideas for upgrading the gauntlet.
I must say, it's refreshing to see young blood like Mr. Olney's coursing through Calico. We'll need his vital spirit if we're to rebuild the Institute's power and vigor. Well done, son.
I think we may have given him a few too many vaults.
Glad to see you're in good shape, but we've got a situation. In order to keep your condition quiet, Amelia told Harrow you died. He's pulled rank and is sending us out on money-grubbing errands while Felicity's building her army.
Harrow's head knows what's right, but his heart is tainted by lust for power and money.
It's gonna get worse now that he got promoted. One wrong move and we're dead in the water.
The one right move, and you could catch her and end this war. On the subject of moving...
You know what? Maybe let's wait for the doc to give the all clear before we start unbinding anyone.
Oh, Edgar. Harrow's not an idiot. Without the Institute, this country would turn into a blood feast. Now, you tell me, son, what's more important? His approval or ending this war before it started?
What did you see while Felicity was in your head?
Death. Horrible monsters appearing out of nowhere. Fire, smoke, and boxcars. Scores of them. Filled with blood.
That's how she's transporting the leeches now? By train?
That's not good, sirs. Dickinson is a major cattle railway hub. The trains run in all directions. If there's an outbreak, we won't be able to contain it.
Jesus Christ, what happened here?
Ah!
exclude one.
Thank you.
glorified parasite!
Ugh, how rude! Look at us, facing off like our enemies before us! You stepping out of your cave, dragging your club! Me, tearing you limb from limb and drinking you dry!
Show you how my new gauntlet works!
You may have tamed the lightning and laid traps across the continent, but you're still the same violent beasts you've always been. You just invented bigger and better clubs. Progress, with no thought spared for those paying the mortal cost of their quest for glory. That is true vampirism! My kind would never leave one of their children to die, crying in the gutter.
I won't let you turn them!
You don't listen! They don't matter, Jesse Rentier. The sooner you understand that, the better.
Hurts.
think you're gonna make it in time, girl.
What now? You're too scared to face me in your own flesh?
Humanity exists within cycles. If you live long enough, you notice the patterns that govern it. The pendulum may swing left and right, but ultimately things remain the same. Exploitation, pain, and misery. It may look different, but it persists. The only way out is to break that pattern.
You're a hero!
She's still here, which means the transports aren't ready. I must have caught her off guard. And now she's scared I might be able to stop her.
Let me test!
now?
About to leave the station. Do you hear them singing? That's humanity's requiem. You can be mankind's last sad note, or you can be part of a new opening chord of progress. It's only natural to feel fear while standing on the precipice of change. Sometimes what you need is a little push. Try not to kill him, my child. Let it break poor William's heart.
Thank you. Huh.